context of my removal from IIT BHU as a visiting faculty, I think we need to examine this allegation of being an Axalite, or as the Times of India says, I was involved in some unwanted activities. So what exactly were these activities? We helped a homeless woman named Champa, who used to live on the streets in the Lanka market outside the BHU campus with her three little children. Two students of IIT BHU, Electronics Engineering Department, Neeraj Jhelaria and Rahul Khurana, spent their own money to rehabilitate this woman. They got her a room in a nearby village, and today she has her own home. Even though the two sons don't live with her, but her daughter stays with her, and she later got rupees 50,000 as help from the Chief Minister's office because of the intervention of an IAS officer, Vidyan Sampal. Shubham Jalan and Shubham Soni, students of computer science, helped a weak, emaciated, physically challenged woman living in Chittupur village. They fed her, they got her medical treatment, and she has gained the strength to be able to sit on the cot and do little chores in her house. We are supporting the education of about 50 to 55 children in and around villages in BHU. And these students, some of the girls had dropped out, so they have been readmitted, and they're going to school and even college. Two Musahar communities living in villages of Chettupur and Susuwahi next to BHU were literally trapped because of the pakka construction all around them. The passage to the community in Chettupur is so narrow that you can't take a dead body horizontally. It has to be tilted to be taken out of that basti. In Susuwahi, when the last house would have been built, they would have been completely trapped. But because of our intervention, the district administration has decided to give them Indira Awas housing and toilets. And the illegal construction was demolished to make a passage for them, entry and exit from this community. And some NREGA workers in Sir Govardhanpur village were in constant touch with us. We were helping them write their applications, demanding work, demanding pending wages, and used to help them talk to the officials, the BDO and other higher officials. So a lot of people were coming to us to seek help in seeking benefits from various government schemes like the pension scheme and housing scheme and other things. In addition to these things which were done at individual level, we were also raising the awareness of the students on important issues as depletion of water table by the Coca-Cola plant in Mehdiganj, situated about 15 to 20 kilometers outside the city on Allahabad Highway. The students took out a cycle rally and a march against this plant. They questioned the proposed amendment by the Narendra Modi government in the Land Acquisition Act, which were anti-farmer, and a student march was taken out from the BHU gate to the Kashi Vidyapeeth, the two universities of which Acharya Narendra Dev has been the vice chancellor. The march was taken out in his name. There was a lecture film series going on in Acharya Narendra Dev's name inside IIT, in which every week there was a lecture or a film on some social issue. We screened P. Sainath's film on farmer suicides. Subhas Gatade came and spoke on communalization in South Asia. So students were involved in activities, they were engaged in discussion and watching film on social issues of importance, and they were being sensitized to the issues of poverty, inequality, injustice, and they were also seeing a role for themselves in social change. This is what was really troubling the RSS, because if these activities were not going on, then the students who were coming to these meetings and getting involved in activities would probably have been going to RSS Shakhas. And that is, I think, the important reason why this baseless charge is being leveled and why I am being removed.